Ladies, gentlemen, welcome at Florence School of Regulation. I'm Jean-Michel Glachan, the director, and I am in parallel with the 6th India-Europe Smart Grid Workshop, a very exciting and an outstanding opportunity of discussing with Indians about India and Europe. I have with me Mr. Punjari, who being the chairman of the Central Electricity Regulatory Commission, which means the federal regulator.
Yes.
And I would like to ask you a few questions, the two first ones being very general. Mr. Punjari, do you feel with the rapid pace of innovation coming from decentralization and digitalization?
Yeah, this pace and digitization and decentralization are inevitable, and with the technology that is coming in, both renewable and decentralized generation, I think this is going to come. And then the regulator needs to be prepared and then anticipate what exactly is going to happen and how it's going to disrupt the power system, and then keep itself abreast with those development that is happening everywhere and keep the regulatory and ecosystem framework ready, so that this disruption that comes in, technological disruption that comes in, the advantage of those these technologies are taken in terms of efficiency, better operations, and then the benefits gets passed on to the consumers. So these are inevitable, and we need to be prepared for that. We need to look around us and see what is happening in the other countries, like organizations like EU, and understand how they are dealing with that, and exchange ideas and learning experiences, and see what we can apply in our context, subject to, of course, how they become applicable, taking into consideration the local conditions.
Yes, you look optimist with this transformation. What about something I am told about India, that you may look at retail competition? What could this bring to you?
Yeah, we at the national level, we have already unbundled the network, and in India, the electricity sector is a concurrent subject. We have a federal government also has a role in that, and the state governments also have a role in that. And distribution is basically in the domain of the state governments. So we have at the national level, the national grid, we have already unbundled, and at the further part of further way for way ahead for the reforms, we intend to go for the unbundling of the network at the distribution level, and basically make the carriage and content separate, so that the competition comes in, and the benefit of competition in terms of efficiency and then cost reductions and the choice to the consumers are made available to the consumers. Of course, it is the work in progress, because we have these provisions in our Electricity Act, which needs to be amended. Mm. And our process of amendment of the Electricity Act to carry out these reforms needs a consultative process along with all the state governments. So the process is on, and there are debates, and I'm sure in coming months, these issues will get resolved, and there will be a consensus that will emerge, and we will be able to push reforms at the distribution level.
So you are as confident with retail competition like with decentralization and digitalization. Now we can enter maybe deeper into the electricity sector and look at the grids, maybe the transmission grids or the distribution grids. Do you see an evolution of the regulatory frame, like incentive regulation or something like that?
Yeah, we already have for the central network, we already have incentive and disincentive mechanism. We have allowed competition in the national grid. I mean, we have
competition inside the grid.
Inside the grid, in the sense we have a central planning utility who plans the transmission lines, but we have a government entity, corporate, who undertake construction of these lines. So, and about a few years back, we brought in the competition, and some of the lines which are of strategic and national importance, and which government thinks that needs to be done urgently, is allocated to these government entities on cost plus basis. Yes. But rest of the lines are bidded out on tariff based competitive bidding, and that has brought in a lot of private players who build, own, and operate those transmission licenses. There, in those competitive bid projects, along with those cost plus project of the national grid, we have brought in the element of incentive and disincentives.
Yes.
And they have to be available for the specified availability has to be as per the specification of the regulations, and if they don't become available, they get penalized. And of course, there are incentive also if they perform and do the constructions or complete the line in time without cost overrun, time overrun, they get additional return.
So you are very advanced, huh? Because Europeans could learn a lot from these novelties you have for the big transmission grid for India. But maybe we can look at another dimension, the wholesale market. Do you have any plan for, let's say, a typical sequence of day ahead, intraday, and what you call deviation settlement, what we call balancing?
Now, we have power exchange, there are two power exchanges running today, and we have day ahead market. But we, at the moment, we are trying to develop the intraday market segments and new products we try to introduce. And we are also trying to, because the integration of the renewables, we the issue of balancing the grid and deviation settlement has yes. become a very important thing. And as in today in India, we have the deviation settlement based on a administered price mechanism.
Yes,
we have a vector which is basically the lowest variable cost and the highest variable cost, and we have drawn a vector, and along with the frequency we put the deviation settlement price, which we think that was okay when the renewable was not there, when the most of the plants were running on the base load. But with the intermittency of renewables and variability, we think that you know, it should be linked to the market prices. So we already have a draft regulations which is, I think is getting finalized shortly, linking the deviation settlement or balancing to the day ahead market price in the market. And subsequently we are going to have ancillary services market yeah. and also real time market. We don't have a real time market in today we do the scheduling for we have a bid for 15 minutes time block. We want to reduce it to 5 minutes time block so that the issue of the forecasting that renewable phase and then deviation settlement becomes much easier in the 5 minutes blocks.
Yes.
So that's a pilot project we are at the moment undertaking. Depending on the learning, I think we'll get into the regulations part of it. So we are evolving at the moment.
I just have now to congratulate you for the many, many challenges you are facing and all the novelties you are bringing. And not only you as a federal regulator, but also the whole country, India, because India is becoming a leader in this world. And we need the countries leading because many transformations have to be set up. And also, many of your citizens will be very happy to see the electricity sector expanding and becoming more affordable for everyone. Congratulations
you.
To you and to your country. Ladies, gentlemen, you have seen how India is moving, how the federal regulator is deeply taking care of it and the quality of the thinking. And it's a pleasure to see that a new country is ready to become a leader in this moving world and to propose new and innovative solutions for their citizens, but also maybe for the well-being of many other citizens in the world.